Betty, this steak. You sure you don't want some?
No, thank you, Roger. I'm a vegetarian sometimes.
Mona has a little calorie book she keeps on the refrigerator. Always has her nose in there.
Maybe she wants to look good for you.
Isn't that a nice thought?
Well, I was pudgy as a girl, if you can believe it. I came into home ec in the 8th grade with a pattern for big girl pajamas. The teacher asked who I was making the pajamas for. I didn't realize how much weight I'd lost that summer. Swim camp, I guess. Went from tadpole to polywog that year.
Sounds like a lateral move.
When I was little in the summer, we used to swim at night. In a pool, not the ocean. Warm air. Light dancing in the blue.
Night swimming. It's divine.
Sometimes naked. Believe me, on those nights, it was very difficult to go to sleep. You ever experienced that, Don?
Trouble sleeping? Never. Your husband's a funny son of a bitch, you know that, Betty? We used to swim in a quarry.
Huh. By the way, you drop your G's every once in a while. I always thought you were raised on a farm. Someplace with a swimming hole.
They say we go to a commercial break. Brought to you by More Liquor.
You too.
Oh. Jesus, don't tell me it's your anniversary.
No.
Don't worry, Sally got this frosting machine.
Mommy and Daddy. Simple, to the point, colloquial, she writes like her father.
I'll get hers. You get your own. Three on a match.
Never understood that. Is that like three on a horse?
Trench war. First war. They used to say, first man lights up, they notice you. Second man, Jerry takes aim. Third one, Peter Zane.
But the professional wisdom says that one of our guys came up with that as a way to sell matches.
You tell your kids there's no Santa Claus?
He'd never do that. Tell us another story. A true one, though.
Well, my father was in the trenches with a bayonet. Think about that. Poking a man to death 3 feet away from you. What does that sound like?
Don never talks about the war.
The war? Oh, his war, you mean?
Not much to say. You boys used up all the glory.
We did, didn't we? Of course, my old man will always have one on me, that bayonet. My biggest hit came when we were running oil down to the islands in the South China Sea. The Pacific was all about gasoline. People forget that. You know what? I don't like to talk about it either.
Oh, dear. I'm sorry.
Not much.
Now you have to tell us.
Well, the third day we picked up a Dyna circling the convoy, a recon plane. They were mapping us for the NIP suicide submarines up ahead. Chitons, basically warheads with motors. It made us feel good to know we had such a dedicated enemy.
That's one way of thinking about it.
Hey, maybe I was bored, but I thought we should get that little plane.
Bored? What about scared? That never comes into these stories.
You're making me look bad in front of the lady.
That's impossible. Finish your story.
Well, we gave it to him. Right at 12 o'clock. He was going away from us, but we hit him. I watched him dive into the waves just beyond the horizon. And it was strange because we knew it was over for him. But we didn't see or hear much. The next 4 hours, I took us off course just to swing by. Looking for a hole in the ocean, I guess. We saw the wreckage. No chute, no body. It's incredible that something that heavy can float.
Isn't that something?
But they gave you a medal.
They did. But not for that, it was for drinking. Could something be done about this sadness?
You want to switch to gin?
Did you check the golf bag?
I have something out in the garage left over from New Year's.
I don't care if it has ants in it.
Shh. Roger, please, the kids.